Electroplating 3D prints is underestimated. Not only is it possible to finish them with a real metal layer, no, the haptic and the irresistible shine create what lacquering and shiny filament fail at. How it all works and how to do it yourself with a little skill, you will learn in this video. Have fun! For this video, I tried plating different types of prints, starting with the FDM print. For the surfaces to shine nicely after plating, they have to be as smooth as possible. FDM layers are immediately visible and should be eliminated. Filler spray and sandpaper do a good job. Not all 3D prints can be sanded easily. So I printed this indie amulet in PVB and smoothed it with the isopropanol steamer or vaporizer. Unfortunately, a lot of details were lost in the process, so I made the whole thing again with the resin printer. I didn't regret that, details are crisp and clear and some kind of yellowish. So let's get started. What do we have here? Two indie amulets made of resin, two metal filament Business Central logo coins, a multi-component sickle from the Asterix comics, it's PLA, and a big cartridge, also PLA. You have to believe me that before we can plate it, these 3D prints have to be made electrically conductive. This is done either with the expensive silver spray or its cheaper brother, the copper spray. I have had good experience with the copper spray. You can apply it very thinly and it conducts very well. Okay, let's jump right in. Plating is basically quite simple. You need an appropriate sized vessel, which you fill with an electrolyte, i.e. a liquid containing metal ions. Then you place metal plates in the bath, which you connect to the positive pole of a power source. If the object to be electroplated is now connected to the negative pole of the power source, the ions move in the directed electrical field and deposit on the object. But before we put the 3D print in the electrolyte, we have to degrease it and rinse it with distilled water. This process is very important. Everything connected correctly? Then it is time to switch on the power supply. I now regulate to approximately 1.4 volts. The bright copper electrolyte I use ideally works at this voltage. The 3D print should now first get a thick layer of copper, so I leave the bath for about 2 hours. Why copper? Well, first of all, it's relatively cheap and I can produce a relatively thick metal layer. Due to the added brightener in that solution, the object is usually very shine at the end, very shiny. And it is precisely this shine that is crucial for the later applied metals to also shine. So this is very important. Be careful to rinse and dry the freshly plated parts directly with distilled water. Copper immediately oxidizes uncontrollably, which is rather a hindrance for the further processes. But I'm already quite satisfied with the first layer. That was the most difficult part. We will now apply further metal layers with a galvanic pen. These layers can be, for example, palladium and then gold. For this, we put a graphite anode into the pen and over this a non-woven fabric. Then we connect the pen to the positive pole of the power supply. When the non-woven is now coated with an electrolyte and a voltage is applied, the ions are deposited on the copper. The prerequisite is that the copper object is connected to the negative pole, of course. But first degrease and rinse again. Then set the voltage to, in this case, 4 to 5 volts, connect the 3D print to the minus pole and move it in circular motions over the workpiece. After a short time, you will notice a change. The longer you move the pen over the copper, the thicker the layer underneath. Palladium is expensive and in this case should only serve as a thin barrier layer between the copper and the gold, so that it does not turn rosé gold later, and it will if you don't. Okay, this also worked very well for the other pieces. And now I have a nice palladiumized collection of 3D prints here. Except for two, I now want to gold plate everything. I'm using 24K gold electrolyte for this, which is cheeky expensive but great to plate. The process is the same as for the palladium. Okay, oh, but wait, if you have such a disgusting catch basin full of electrolyte and degreaser residues like I do, then I recommend that you fill it into a plastic bottle and drive it to the recycling center. Don't just pour it down the drain, it's highly polluting. So, last stop, gold. Power on, cleaning, safety goggles on, circle, circle, circle. Don't spill the electrolyte, let it flow back into the container. When you're satisfied with the result, just stop. And with that, you're done. Check it out. It's hard to capture on video, but the metal is stunningly shiny. It feels extremely real. It's cold, it's smooth, it reflects very well. Still, you can make mistakes. The two Business Central coins, I set a little too much voltage, making the surface duller than I wanted. It's also a test of patience. Placing all the parts one after the other takes many hours. But if you want real metal, this could be a good option for you. I hope you liked it. If you want to know more, write it in the comments. Moin moin.